Hello, my name is Vijay, and I'm a volunteer of Mohindi Foundation. Very soon, we will be celebrating Mahashivaratri, which is one of the most auspicious days in the Hindu calendar. So before that special occasion, I'd like to speak to you a little bit about Kailash, Shiva, and Shivaratri. So Kailash is a mountain in Tibet, which is one of the major power centers on Earth and considered to be the crown chakra of the Earth. Just as we have chakras and energy centers within our body, the Earth also has similar power centers. And Kailash is considered to be the crown chakra of the Earth. A visit to Kailash is the ultimate pilgrimage. It is the abode of Lord Shiva. However, Shiva is a state, and that state is absolute stillness. Kailash represents that state of absolute stillness. It is like a giant Shivalinga with Abhishek constantly being performed by the clouds in the form of rain, mist, hail, and snow. Many beings in subtle forms from all different realms perform worship to Shiva at Kailash. I have been fortunate enough to go to Kailash twice with Mohanji, the Outer Kora trip in 2014 and Inner Kora in 2016. The grace and presence of Shiva was felt throughout the pilgrimage. Just to share a couple of those, one instance was witnessing beings appearing in light form and taking dips in the Manasa River Lake. This happened on the two nights that we were staying there. Well, the first night I stayed up, looked over the lake and saw various lights in green, yellow, and also red and various other tinges of color. And these would just suddenly appear, would suddenly shoot across, move across very, very quickly, and then suddenly just dip downwards into the lake, come back up, and then disappear. And at one point, I even saw an orb-like structure up in the sky, much, much bigger than the star. And this thing just suddenly appeared out of nowhere. And Mohanji explained to us that these are beings, celestial beings, who are themselves performing their penance to Shiva, and that we should stay well clear of them and leave them alone. The other instance of grace was at the end of the parikrama, when I had completely finished the walk around the whole of the mountain, going on the coach, sitting down, I suddenly just looked up and saw the face of Shiva in cloud form. So you can see the eyebrows, the eyes, the mouth, the ears, and the nose, all perfectly formed. I knocked the person next to me and said, "Look up there, what do you see?" And he, in astonishment, said, "That's Shiva." So there was lots of little instances of grace like that during Kailash. And I feel very, very grateful to Mohanji for allowing me that opportunity to witness and experience these. So who or what is Shiva? Shiva, according to Mohanji, is not a person. Shiva is basically everything. Shiva is the vastness. Shiva is the manifested and the unmanifested. It is a created universe and the uncreated one, the infinite universe which does not have any beginning or end. Shiva is beyond explanation, notion, understanding, or even awareness, because the mind matter that we possess, the mind, intellect, ego, just do not have the capacity to be able to understand Shiva. It is an experience that the experiencer has to dissolve into completely. So what is Shivaratri? Shivaratri is a time when the configuration and conglomeration of the planets, the positioning of the planets, gives us the opportunity to connect to something which cannot be defined through any words. So we, as units of existence, are trying to connect to the vast consciousness, which is the source of everything. So Shivaratri is a day that can help us to connect to the subtlest aspect of ourselves. And through that subtlest aspect, we experience and realize Shiva. So it is a very, very important day. So in order to have that experience, any sadhana that we do has the opportunity to give us that experience. So it's a great day for remembering and reminding ourselves through chanting, through feeling, through experience, and through awareness what and who we really are. The day can be spent chanting Om Namah Shivaya within while focusing on the heart center. Alternatively, fasting, Abhishek of a Shivalinga while chanting or doing meditation. Practices such as connecting to the spine and feeling the breath traveling up and down the spine. So we have organized a 6-day retreat, which is a wonderful opportunity to facilitate and discipline yourself for this Saturday in order to prepare you for the day itself. During the retreat, there will be various group sessions of meditation, listening to the Shiva Kavach chanted by Mohanji, chanting. And this all culminates in a 24-hour group chanting session and Shivaratri discourse with Mohanji. I sincerely hope that you will be able to join us. Om Namah Shivaya. Jai Mohanji.